It's such a beautiful, unexplored paradise, these 8 states I have walked on foot. And when you travel, couple of places of Northeast you come to know. And similar way, when I talk about ASEAN, that's again natural confluence. We have got culture, cuisine, features, our customs, traditions, so many things, similarities are there. So the time has come now that today, for the first time, the Northeast region and the ASEAN with the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, how we can package, what we should package, how we should go ahead. We have got a lot of associations, different associations over here. You have got Producers Association, Directors Associations, IMPA, SINTA. You have got Young Artists Associations. Chhabra Saab had been having a deliberations. A lot of people we have met last time also when Ministry of Tourism, Additional Secretary had come. What I wish to share is you got to package it, whole thing together. And if entire Northeast and ASEAN is clubs together, with all the association and a confluence come over there, by 4 o'clock in the evening, we will have 2 packages, something very nice. The best suggestion which will come from the audience, not from the participant on the dais, the dialogue, the panel discussion, but from the audience, 2 best packages which will come. Choice is yours. Wherever you would like to travel in Northeast, you'll have 3 nights and 4 days free fam tour to that particular place in Northeast. We need to have your suggestion, something concrete. And of course, again, how the entire Northeast and ASEAN to be clubbed together. I have spoken to Fly Dubai, another good suggestion which will come by evening by 4, 4:30. They are ready to give 2 complimentary tickets. Anybody can fly to Dubai and have about 2 nights trip to Dubai. Wonderful and see over there also. With that as a node, little incentive, let me share. And let me go on to the presentation part, what we have got. Can we have the slides coming on that also? Okay, it's not possible. So then how will I show it over here? Sorry? No, presentation is here. I want to just club it. Okay. So ladies and gentlemen, let me just share 5 to 6 slides quickly with you so that we are on the common range, common frequency. When we are talking about Northeast India and the ASEAN together, so we have got 10 countries in the ASEAN and we have got 8 states in the Northeast. So 18 of them together, today the confluence, the melting pot, and we work out something nice from here, how we travel, what we work out, and what we plan. Your technology, Parul, is little advanced. Over here is next slide, whereas there is the previous slide. Anyway, it's a technology, digital technology, no problems. I will take it on yours, what you want to show. Okay, now the next slide which I wish to share over here is, these are various events which have already taken place in the Northeast. We have deliberated on tourism, we have deliberated on health, we have deliberated on education, we have deliberated on IT, telecom, couple of other areas, and today the deliberation takes place with regard to when we are talking about the media entertainment industry. Now, when we are talking about cinematic tourism, it's something very interesting. Every state is interested, every country is interested to promote their tourism the best possible way. They've got road shows, they've got conferences, they've got trade fairs, they've got exhibitions, they've got expos, they've got a display of the talents, whatsoever is being done. But when we talk about cinematic tourism, it's a coining which I did as a part of my PhD, I still recollect. The econometric model which has to be drawn on cinematic tourism, every country is interested to promote tourism. And at the same time, there is no better vehicle than the entertainment industry which can promote tourism. When we club these things two together, the wonders can be done over there because the tourism automatically travels. Varunji, you can come and take this chair. Please come and join me. You're outside. Please come here. Come and join. He's a youngster who was in Phukre earlier. Then Dilwale, and now Phukre 2 part is coming, so I told him before that you release it, you please come over here. Yes. Now, what we wish to share over here is cinematic tourism when we are talking about, ladies and gentlemen, the tourism and the cinema, they have to be clubbed together. And I was talking and I was getting some inputs from Pandey Saab, the Joint Secretary, this morning. We are very keen how we can package the entire Northeast together. We understand what exactly media entertainment is looking forward to in Northeast. And at the same time, when we have got the dignitaries from the ASEAN country, I'm pretty sure there is going to be a competition today. If there are 10 countries, let's see which country takes the fam tour of the media entertainment industry from Bollywood, from Mumbai, first to their country. Let's work it out. Let's package it and let's see it today. Vietnam is looking towards me. Philippines has also looked towards me. Brunei always looks at me. So we will work at it. We will plan on to it. And how do we go by? So let's club together. There should be a fam tour of the media entertainment industry, which should be taken, and we should package it. We should see what incentives, perks, privileges, and better offers are taken care of with regard to media entertainment and with regard to cinematic tourism, with regard to entire Northeast region, and with regard to entire ASEAN together, what we can do with the media entertainment industry. Once again, deep gratitude and thanks. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you. 5 year old, but I've got a child in me which is 25 year young. And that is the one which takes me. And although I didn't want to share in public, but let me share. My wife is right over here. That's my energy. That's my backbone. And that's the lady because of whom she has nourished me, chiseled me, developed me, and made me somewhere acceptable human being in the society. Thank you very much. Thank you.
You left nothing for us to say. Behind every successful man is, well, of course, a lovely lady there. Thank you so much for that. Thank you, Mr. Mehul Kumar, Mr. Shyam Shroff, and Ms. Rani Hazarika, the very famous singer. Thank you so much. You're in the audience. We're definitely going to listen to your tunes, but after some time. Thank you for being here with us.
A very good morning, good afternoon to all the dignitaries present on the dais, off the dais, distinguished artists, people from the media, entertainment industry, film industry. This is one industry which holds tremendous soft power. It connects people, it connects cultures, it connects humanity, and it connects them emotionally. It connects them very powerfully. The economic integration is something which comes with lot of other things, but the soft power of media, entertainment, film, we have seen globally. Even if you don't know people, even if you don't know language, but you pick up films from different parts of the world and you start enjoying them, start enjoying, especially the Indian films are known for their music, songs, dances, colors. And this is what has actually been splashed all over the world and gives that emotional connect with the culture of this place. Dr. Sharma mentioned about the strong Indian diaspora. We also have another partner country here, Philippines. Their diaspora is equally strong. They are also all over the world like Indians. And they get integrated very well in the society. The today's initiative, it's a maiden initiative. We had a lot of apprehensions because Mumbai is a busy city. And getting people in Mumbai is always a challenge. And especially people from the film industry. But we thought we must take this plunge. We must take this initiative because if we were to do this first program in Guwahati or Shillong or Tawang, or anywhere in Northeast, then getting all the film industry people, media entertainment industry people to Northeast would be difficult. And therefore, to begin with, let us try to create a platform to connect people of all the three parts, the Northeastern region of India, the ASEAN countries, and the Bollywood film industry. Bombay is the capital for this. Today, India produces nearly 2,000 films in terms of numbers, largest in the world every year. But still, in terms of our global revenue, in terms of our overall size, we are not that big in value terms. We are still about, the global revenues are still about 6 to 7% of the total revenues that come from the film industry, which is not, we should be actually targeting to double it. And it is possible. And this actually just requires rich content of films with which people can connect. And that is what we were discussing in the morning, that the ASEAN region and the Northeastern region, they have so much in common in their history, in their culture, in their way of life, that the stories can be picked up, content can be picked up by script writers, people who have the imagination and creativity, and they can weave around that content beautiful stories connecting people. And why don't we initiate a project with the film industry where countries of this region and Northeast, they come together and try to create film which is shared in terms of connect by people living in the entire region. It was mentioned in the beginning, and this is true, that after the World War II, the borders became rather difficult. Prior to that, the international borders, the nation-state concept was very loose, as a result of which borders were by and large porous. People moved freely from one country to another. In Burma, which is now Myanmar, people used to move across. People used to move across to Thailand, to Malaysia. Some of the countries didn't exist at that time. It was free movement of people because nobody had any apprehension about each other.